Why don't you find out who I am? According to the man, he lost his memory because of the flash. He came to a sense that he was wandering the prison with no idea where he was or where he had come from. Only a single clue. The woman's brooch. Take a look at it. Beautiful brooch. Must have been the work of some well-known craftsman. I now recognize it must mean something for me, a man to be carrying it. Got the brooch from him. Be a difficult quest, but please. And we are back. So, last time we beat the Reaper boss in B2, but we had to bail out a little bit after the fight before we were able to set up the fully activate the elevator shortcut. So we still have more of a long-winded route through the dungeon to do today. Before we can just skip through to B3. Keep forgetting that this game doesn't actually use the left analog stick for, the things that most games use left analog sticks for. Any chests over here I can grab? Or quick exit items? Also, I have a kitty. One over here. All right. Extra map stone, I can't use it yet, but like my plan is for once Durgan changes class to Samurai, they'll equip it. Unfortunately, ninjas don't have two weapon fighting. It's a bummer. That'd be a nice, useful skill for that class to have. You have one, you have two, one, you have one, you have two, two. I'll just keep the second one in Durgan's inventory for now. Right. And lift. And L2 is the turn the map on and off. Okay, forgot what that was. Oops, sorry, Miss Kitty. Didn't mean to bonk you with that. Do some crafting with that. We get next time we hop back to town. And I do appreciate the fact that the game does let you use this for using materials for usable items as well. Also, the game does not do auto turnaround when you press back, which is actually also kind of a Grand Wizardry tradition. Might and Magic was more of the kind where if you hit back, it would have you turn around instead of just backing up blindly. So, Reaper or no Reaper this time? But this Reaper is still here, and it's still an unbeatable opponent. Look at the Rush, so we can take out the Harpies. I actually don't mind these guys crying for assistance at this point now, because now I want the extra XP. Because I need to level up Durgan, because once Durgan levels up, then he can change class to Samurai. And finally use that katana in his inventory. No Reaper here this time, that's good. It's interesting once you play enough disc-based JRPGs, the single-player RPGs, you can tell where the presentation is being used to mask load times. Alright. Ooh, okay, I can use that. So we searched over in there last time, and we've got that area fully. This level is now fully mapped. I like the little rats we just have scurrying around. We're not quite high enough, heavily enough equipped to just off these guys in one hit now yet. And not. Jurgen and Ricardo, because they have more hit points now. Because they have less hit points now. All right. whole bunch of thief stuff. Ooh. A longsword. Hopefully that's a magic weapon. Alright. Did I get myself turned around? No, I didn't. Alright, yep, I did a full lap around to get the stairs over here. And back down. I'm debating having Sarah change class to Bishop. Just for the ability to identify items in dungeon, but I don't want to have her. Like. Having somebody get freaked out by identifying a. Cursed item is enough of a concern that I don't want to risk it. Ooh, the magic stone. Nice. Item. Alright, priest spell, priest damage based spell. So Kyo can use it? So can Kalo. Ah, another ninja. Plus a bunch of thieves. So, we're gonna rush. Won't kill the thieves, but it will kill the orcs, which just leaves things, makes things easier on my part. Alright, so that opens up that passage for later. So the pixies can cast sleep spells, so we're gonna start with the rush again. Oof, that's a bad hit on Kyo. I can still hold off on the healing for now. It's a big enough heal that I can wait until we hit max, until we get closer to halfway. Now I can cast healing. All right. All right, this is trapped. Nice, okay. Okay, that's all right, so that's a one-way door there. Okay. I'll finish up exploring this level. Actually, if we do a rush again, that might be enough to finish him. How much damage it took to kill him last time. Yep. I'm still surprised that ninjas can't use katana weapons. Oh, that is a weapon that I would be really, really useful for, I'm sure I haven't finished, properly explored this for the dungeon yet. That ninja is probably something that's really useful for Kyo, now that I think about it. Okay, so this is gonna be tricky. I'm in. So I'll cancel. Assassinate the bogey cat. Let's start. Double slash on you. All right. Alright, then moves the bridge back up. Don't have much in terms of undead this level yet, which is fine. Maybe killing the Reaper got rid of the undead, which actually I would not object to at all. Alright. Double slash. Let's... We can definitely get the Highwayman. Spell cancel. Oh, yeah, the ninja's actually fairly loud in hit points. Okay, that's good to know. One of those cases with the level up and a gear upgrade, we can probably just... be able to take him out with a rush as well. I think once we get to the shortcut, all right, Leonard Paralysis attack. Okay. Okay. Leave you alone. We have somewhere we need to go. Oh, there's undead for the first time. All right. All right, we'll try spelling them again. Oh, come on. Finish mapping here.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. And also consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and any future Let's Plays. Also, please consider backing my Ko-fi. Toss me a few bucks also helps support the show, and it's not a monthly obligation or anything like that.